wherever he leads us. What do we do then? Then we turn around and we go and tell those who are out there that are weary that we did sow that seed into, and let them know that, look, God still loves you. There is still hope.
Yeah.
You don't have to stay in that way that you are in. God has a way out. So what do? You go back to the soil, the seeds that you sow that were terrible. You uproot it, and you now take your ways, convert to God's ways, and he will do the rest. Why we should be sitting here by ourselves in seats. There's so many gaps in the church. This church should be filled to the rim. But you gotta be willing to sow. You gotta be willing to sow what it is that God has given you. The thing I like about God is this. No matter how old you get into the way of his will, you still gotta learn. You still gotta learn. You still gotta progress. It's not just stable. It's not, you're not gonna just stay still. But you gotta keep moving forward. So that means what? That no matter how old your buddy is, you still gotta go witness. You still gotta go tell people about the goodness of God. You still gotta go out there and tell them that God has saved you. Some of us got a testimony that we don't want nobody to hear because we're ashamed. But that testimony can set thousands of people free. That testimony can let people know that I was once bound, but now I'm free.
Yeah.
How many of y'all wanted to give God your testimony? Go out there to the world and preach the gospel, and those who believe shall be baptized. How many of y'all wanted to do that?
Amen.
How many of y'all wanted to give God your all?
Amen.
You gotta be able to put in to get something out.
Yeah.
I like the psalmist when he says, nothing for nothing leaves what? Nothing. But you gotta have something if you wanna be with me. The Lord is telling you, you gotta give me something if you want to be with me. You gotta give me your life. You gotta give me your testimony. You gotta give me your heart. You gotta give me your mind, your soul, and your spirit.
Yes, Lord.
You gotta give me all these things so I can do mighty great things in your life. When I think about Sister Mother Teresa and how she gave her all, even to her, you know, her oldest age, she died giving.
Yes.
She died giving.
Yes. Yes.
She didn't know she didn't care how old she got. But as long as the kingdom was put forth, she was doing her job.
Yeah.
Don't sit down on your testimony, saints. And don't even get angry about the truth. Just receive it so that it can heal whatever is going on in your life.
Yeah.
Receive whatever he has for you that may change it all around. We're sitting right now on things that we cannot change. But God can. God can. God can change anything. As long as you want to convert to his way. So I didn't want to come here. I didn't want to stay long. I just wanted to tell you that. We are, if you're going to be a child of God, you have to be like Psalms 1 said. I am like the tree planted by the rivers of water, yielding forth his fruit in season, and whose leaves do not wither. Whatever you touch shall be able to be prosperous. Whatever you do shall not fail. But you must first convert over to his will. Convert over to his will. Are you invested in the crown? Are you invested in good ground? Are you invested in good ground? Ask yourself that question. What am I doing with my life? I investing what God has given me to souls to be saved? You are not to be converted to the world, but you convert those in the world in Christ.
That's right.
We don't change for the worse, we change for the better. So that's it. I'm finished. But I want you to want to leave this with you today. If you don't care about anything else in your life, care about others. Care about others. We all have big families in this church. And ain't nobody's family perfect. But God is. He can make them what they need to be. But you got to will, have be willing to allow him to use you.